Hi, this is a minute of Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now this week I want to talk about where to get audio to put in your apps. Okay, so a few days ago I got an email from somebody asking me about game assets, like more specifically audio, like where do you get the music and the sound effects and the jumps and the gunshots and all that kind of stuff. And I answered his email, but I thought I'll talk a little bit about how I do that for some of our games this week. So now this might be, I'm gonna show you the resources that we use or the resources that we've used in the past. But it's not like a comprehensive list because I know there's other you know resources out there, and I thought if I can tell you what I used, and some of you might be using something that's better, and then you could put that in the comments, and then you know we could all you know all of us developers could get like you know really smart. So have a look at my screen over here. Now more often than not, when I need like music or sound effects for a game or an app, I'll go to Audio Jungle, which is one of the Envato sites. Now Envato, they do like Theme Forest and you know and Graphic River and Photodune and all that kind of stuff. But they also have like a lot of good music, a lot of good royalty-free music. Now, yeah, royalty-free. That's what you should be looking for. It's a confusing term because you know it has the word free in it. You think that you don't have to pay for it, but what it means is you don't have to pay like you don't have to pay royalties on it, but you have to pay to use it. So again, over here at Envato. For an example, we had a game where we had gunshot sounds, which was a language learning game called Secret Agent Mandarin. But for there, like I could just type in gunshot, and there's lots of different effects, and it's like you know $1 each. And if you hear this, you know, nice, you know, you just listen. You hear it says Envato as a game. And some of them are packs, so you can like you know, have lots of them together, for $5, and it's really useful. Also got things here like you know we do the bubble bath games, and each one has like a different music that's in the background. So you know we just released the Italian one, we're doing a German one now, so one of the things I will do is look for German music. But then because it's a game and you don't know how long it's going to be, you know, I don't want something that's a minute 20 seconds, what I'll do is I'll look for a loop. So I'll do German music loop here, and it'll come up like with lots of different things, and I'll have a look down here and look at the price, look at you know how much it costs to use it and everything. And let's say I use this Charlie Chews Bubblegum. That's too slow to start. I'll just, a German song waltz, that's perfect. Audio Jungle. Now you have to think how annoying this is going to get as the user plays the game. And then this is a minute, 13 seconds. The nice thing about Audio Jungle also is you can say, you know, how much you're willing to pay, the length. So really, I want like a loop, but I don't want it to be too big because it'll make the APK or the app too big. So I'll look for something that's like, say, and you don't want it to be too short because if it loops too short, it really gets annoying. We have a few that are like that and everyone complains about them. Let's see, so if I do 45 seconds, so I want between 0 and 45 seconds, it gives me, let's see this one here. Festive music part. See, that might be okay. But if you go in here and look at this, you can look at the licenses. Now the licenses here is like a 10,000 copy limit if it's for software. Now you could go through and do like a bigger one if you're gonna have more downloads. But you gotta think about when you're releasing it, you might wanna just do it with the standard license to begin with and see how it goes, and then go back in later and you could, you know, increase the license later if you need to. But that's like a really good resource. However, it's not free, and like say $12, depends on how much you're gonna make. A lot of times the apps, you know, you're not even gonna make that $12 back, so you might want to try some other resources. There's one here that we've used quite a lot in the past, and it's called the AS3SFXR, and it's got like 8-bit sounds here. So here we go, like say coin pickup, laser, explosion, and you could adjust these things here and kind of generate your own sound and export it as a wave. So we've used this, you know, quite a few times before, just for those little short sounds. You know, it's like half a second long. You know, when somebody gets hit or some little thing, you know, like a wrong answer, you just want something to go off there. That's a really good site for that. Now, When I was looking at this earlier, I saw that he did, the developer here did come up with a new one here called Chiptone, which looks a lot better than that other one. And it looks pretty much the same kind of thing. And it's really kind of, you know, kind of cool just to be able to go through and adjust these sounds and, you know, basically be able to download them and use them. Like he says, you could use them for whatever you want. And that's a nice way to put some of those sound effects into your app. Now, if you're doing something like music, for your app that's not Audio Jungle, say like you're doing a video, there are lots of resources out there where you get royalty-free music. Now, YouTube will reject your video if you're using a bit of music that you don't have permission for. If they don't do it immediately as you upload it, they'll do it eventually. But YouTube does have down here, if you use YouTube, I use YouTube all the time, obviously. Down here, if you go down to the Create library, if you go into the dashboard, go down to Create, and they have this audio library where they have this music that you can use for the videos. And it's actually like a huge amount of music. They have sound effects too. Let's go. So try some of these here. So that could be like the new introduction to the minute of Overpass. But anyway, it's a really good resource to go through and have a look at. Now, if you're doing something like voiceovers, like, you know, all of our bubble bath games we have voice actors involved. So like, I'm not going to go in there and speak Spanish. I'm not going to speak Mandarin, even though I can speak Mandarin, but I'm sure I've got a rough, you know, a pretty bad accent. So what I'll do is I'll go through and I'll hire somebody from other places. I'll hire voice actors a lot of time, and I do that through Upwork. And Upwork you might use for developers too. I've had trouble with developers through Upwork before. You may not have, but for voice actors, it's great. So you just go in here, you know, create a job. I've just done one here just the other day for Italian and for German. You say, you know, a short-term job. Say you want to spend some. You basically, I put like a low bid and, you know, see who comes for it. If they want paid more, they'll make you an offer for more. Say I want to do it for $100 for like all these words and all this audio, and they might say, you know, actually we'll do it for 200, and then you could decide. But usually with Upwork, once I post a job for a voice actor, which is down here under design and creative voice talent, and then you could go through and say I want James Earl Jones type voice to say, you know, game over or something like that, then that's something to do too. And you could say, you know, put it like a low bid and see if anybody comes for that, or a low fixed price cost. So that's just some of the resources that we use. It's not, you know, it's not an exhaustive list. I know other people have showed me other audio resources out there that are actually really good too. But you know, these are the ones that I've used, so I haven't used any of the other ones. If there's some that you use that you think is really good, then again, please put it in the comments, because you know it'd be really good to know. And that's it. I hope that's been helpful. I'll talk to you next week.
Hey, I hope you liked that video. Now, if you did like it, I'd really appreciate it if you click on the like button down below. And if you want to know more about app development, app marketing, all that kind of stuff, now we share everything we learn here. So I make this video once a week, every Friday, or at least I try to get it done every Friday. Sometimes it might slip into Saturday. But we put these out once a week. So if you want to see more of them, click on the subscribe button, and then that way you won't miss anything. And if you want to find out, you know, follow us up more on a day-to-day basis, you can always follow, join us on Snapchat. We put out snaps to our story, like, you know, several a day. So we kind of go through, you know, how things are working in the app market, things on a day-to-day basis, like in 10-second chunks. And Snapchat's kind of my way of trying to be young and trendy and all that kind of stuff, you know. So, and finally, oh, if you could leave a comment, that would be awesome. So. And I know you don't want to leave a comment. I never leave comments because I, you know, who wants to leave comments, right? But I'll make it easy for you. All you have to do is, if you like the video, put gnarly, because it's an 80s term and, you know, I'm a child of the 80s. What can I say? If you didn't like it, put bogus. And if you didn't think anything of it, just put eh, right? And finally, now, if you go onto the App Store, either Google Play or iTunes, look up one of the Overpass apps and download it and leave a review. That would also be something that would be really, really helpful, because that, you know, keeps things churning the same way you want to happen for your app. So that's it. I'll talk to you next week.